Hello there, this is Ujjwal. I'm back with another video today, creating this cute little card with adorable Lawn Fawn stamps. I'm a big fan of Lawn Fawn. I love their cute designs, and I bought this stamp set last year but haven't had the chance to use it, so I'll be using the stamp set as well as the Polaroid die, and I kind of want to create a scene inside that Polaroid, so that's what I'm going to do. Apart from the die and the stamp, I have plans of using the Tombow dual brush pens. These are water based and they work like watercolors, so it makes the task really easy. So now to start with, I have this watercolor paper from Canson Montwell. I'll leave the link in the description box below, and I'm tracing the inside of the Polaroid with a pencil to get the idea of where my scene actually goes. So just be very light-handed with a pencil mark, and it won't show in the end project. And now I am using some watercolor safe archival ink, so it won't bleed when you watercolor, and I'm stamping the two flamingos. So I want to create a little sunset love scene with this little Polaroid, and I will be creating the scene using some masking today. So masking is basically protecting your front images and working on the background at the same time. So I have these full adhesive post-it notes, and I'm stamping those two flamingos again onto the post-it notes. So you can see, instead of just that little top, the whole of the note has this same temporary adhesive, which will make it easier for me to stick my masks down on the paper. So I went ahead and cut around the images, and I'm going to protect those stamped images with this mask and then work on creating the background. To create the sun, I'm going to mask that as well. So I'm using a 1-inch punch, and I punched out a piece, a circle, from the same post-it sheet, and I'm going to just place it right behind the flamingo, so it kind of looks like the sun is setting behind them. And now we are going to work on the background. So I'm using some distress inks today, and I'm using a blending foam and a paper richness blending tool, and just working the color here. So around the sun, I want an orange shade, and then kind of blend it outside to be more pink and purplish and setting, like the setting sun kind of a feel. So I'm just applying some color with the blending tool to the area near the masked sun, and then I'm using this picked raspberry color, which is a really nice pink color all over the rest of the scene. And once I've done that, I'm using the a shade of purple, Seedless Preserves, I think it is called. I will list down all the details in the description box, all the products that I've used. And once I have the background, I removed the first mask of the sun, and now I'm adding some yellow using the mustard seed distress ink. And you can see that I have that sun, that sunny glow, and then the orange, and then kind of, you know, blending it outwards towards the horizon with the pinks and purples and all that. So once I have the background, I'm going to remove this mask that I had on the flamingos, and you can see how well that has turned out. And I'm going to go back with the brush pens and start coloring in the flamingos. So this color is really highly pigmented, so you need very little color with the pens on the paper, and you can just blend it out with water later on. So I'm adding two shades of pink here, more purplish, and then this hot pink magenta kind of a shade. I will again list down the exact numbers of the pen that I've used here in the description box. And now I'm blending these colors with a water brush. You could use a regular brush and some water, and that works perfectly fine too, but I just find the water brush a little bit more neater and non-messy, so I prefer to use this. And just color in quickly. You don't have to be really worry about so much about perfectly coloring it in, because they will look cute no matter what. So I trimmed down the finished piece to the size of the Polaroid. I have cut down the Polaroid from an ivory color sheet as well, and then I have the matting sheet and the card base ready to go. And now I'm going to add final touches to this card. So I decided to add something more to the background, so I've put the mask back onto the images, and now I'm adding some coconut trees or palm trees or whatever they're called in the background, using a really dark green and brown kind of an ink, so that they look like really, you know, they're really in the background like a shadow. And then again, since these inks are water based, I can go back with my water brush and smoothen out the stamping if I have to. And that is what I did. I just added another coconut tree and then I removed the mask, and now I have something more to the background. And now we are going to assemble the cards. I'm going to just stick the Polaroid frame to the scene that we have created here and trim down any excess that I might have. So you can see I have some excess on the top. I'll trim that down, and I will also add the little mat that I created for the card base. Now this gray will really kind of contrast all the white and the color that's going on there. And now I'm building the sentiment. So I'm using this Hero Arts neon ink. It's like really hot pink. And I just stamped V Flamingo together. I think it's really cute. And then I added some hearts as well and a flower to the little lady flamingo there. And now I'm adding some twine just to accent it a little bit more. The bows and all, it just kind of helps the design to pop up a little bit more. And now we are just going to go ahead and color in those hearts. I adhered the Polaroid frame using some foam tape to the background, and now I'm just coloring in the flower and the hearts, and adding in some black to the beaks, just the little final touches that are really, really important and really make that card, take that card to another level. So I just added that, you know, detail to the beak. And here is the inspiration image from where I took the inspiration for this scene. So you can see the setting sun in the background and the love theme, the hearts. And I think I had a blast and it turned out really cute. So if you like the video, make sure to like and subscribe and share this video with your friends, and let me know what you'd like to see more, and I will be happy to share. So I'll see you again another time. Take care. Bye-bye.